In the past few months, Varun mostly and others have taken it upon themselves to get me all dressed up for my shoots. So by turns, I've been a bodyguard, a hipster, a zamindar of sorts. But do the clothes make it the man? Because underneath all that, I'm just me, right? A passionate motorcyclist by vocation and a very, very lucky man by avocation. But why are we talking about my dress sense or the lack thereof? It's because of the motorcycle we're riding today. That is the brand new Honda CB200X. It's the Hornet 2.0 wearing Hornet 2.1 clothes. If you think of the Hornet as the teacher's pet, that is its twin, but it wants to be a little bit more mischievous. It needs to look like it belongs here, but what it really lives for is over there. So, what kind of mischief can you get up to on the CB200X? Let's find out. So in terms of design, the largest amount of work Honda has done on the CB200X obviously is the styling of this motorcycle. And that is actually a nice job because it is inspired by the CB500X, the Africa Twin, and it does look rather nice. There is a lot of presence, and I honestly could not ride this motorcycle for any length of time without people turning around to see what it is. But if you think about it, underneath this is a completely stock Hornet, but the styling does change a few things. So this handlebar is mounted on absolutely massive riser, so it's very high up and you sit as you would on an ADV. It's upright, and I know a lot of people will find that more comfortable than a slightly sporty tuck that the Hornet puts you into. Similarly, the styling, the headlight and all of that does look nice, but what Honda shouldn't have done is cut corners, because for example, they've integrated indicators into the handguard, and these are basic plastic handguards, but they've integrated the Hornet's indicators in there, and honestly, that doesn't look good. So overall, it's a mixture of a lot of good things and a few bad things. This is a nice looking street bike. It only looks like an ADV though. It doesn't actually go like an ADV. So as I said, big fancy commuter, and that means this engine should look familiar to you because this is exactly the same engine as in the Hornet, same gearbox, no changes at all. So it does wear a 200 badge, but that's a 184cc engine. And that means performance has to be modest, because remember, the X is now also carrying about 4 or 5 kilos extra weight. So in this segment, there are motorcycles that are faster than this, there are motorcycles that are more refined than this, and most likely there will be motorcycles that are more fuel efficient than this as well. But when you buy the X, what you're getting is a motorcycle that does its best work in city traffic, where it's easy, refined and quite calm to ride, and out on the highway it will do modest cruising speeds as well, something like 70-80 kilometers an hour. But what you'll get if you get an X is a little bit more space, because this is a physically larger motorcycle. So whether you're putting a pillion on the back or a little bit of luggage, this will offer you a little bit more space than the Hornet. How does it fit into the segment though? That's a story for the comparison test. That engine goes into the exact same frame as the Hornet, and nothing has changed. The wheelbase, the suspension, everything is the same, and therefore the feelings that you get from the motorcycle also are the same. We'd complained that the Hornet was a little too stiffly suspended, and the same is true for the 200X as well. Hit a sharp bump and you will feel it, and on most roads, the X could stand to be a lot more settled than it is right now. But on the flip side, the handling, just like the Hornet, is actually quite nice. It's an eager, sharp motorcycle that turns well into corners, and you do enjoy the slightly taller feeling riding position and the sense that you're riding a slightly larger, slightly more special motorcycle. But ride them back to back and you'll be surprised at how similar the experience is. And that brings us to the next point that we have to make, which is, what do we think of the motorcycle as a whole? So let's go back to the clothes. The influencers would have you believe that they're all about form, but clothes are essentially about function. From hiding your nakedity to protecting you from feeling cold, for example. If you had cargoes, you'd gain storage. If you had a hat, it would prevent the sun from burning your aloe vera skin. And in that sense, the X does gain some advantages from its new skin. At the most basic level, the ergonomics are upright, and that's quite nice. That's a reason to get the X if you can justify the difference in price between the Hornet and this motorcycle. But think about it like this. If Honda had given this motorcycle 20 or 30mm more suspension travel at either end, a little bit more ground clearance, this would be a lot more than a Madagascar twin on Instagram. If this engine had gained 20 or 30cc more, it would justify the 200 in the name a whole lot better. As successful as Honda is with the Activa in India, the motorcycle market continues to elude the world's biggest two-wheeler brand right here in India, from their smallest bikes to their big bikes, and unfortunately, the 200X is right there in that set. So the X, it's just frosting on a relatively weak cake.